Rigging Station, brought to you by Windrider, the finest foul weather gear for any climate.
Hey guys, welcome to this episode's Rigging Station. Want to talk to you in detail about these spinning outfits. You know, again, the premise of today's show is coming out here looking for schoolie dolphin, looking for action to put everybody, you know, on a hot bite. But these guys that don't have the outriggers, these guys that don't have full arsenals of conventional gear, that don't have all of the, you know, fancy schmancy stuff, okay? But everybody's got spinning outfits. That's where we all grew up, fishing spinning outfits. And they're so versatile. I don't know what fisherman doesn't have a variety of classes of spinning rods. So that's what we decided to do today, is just leave that hardcore gear, that conventional stuff at home in the rigging station in the garage, and to just bring out some spinners. But I want to tell you what we brought and why, what my logic is here. So again, as we're running offshore here, we're looking for anything. We're running and gunning. We're looking for weed patches. We're looking for floating debris, anything that could scream fish here. And at that particular case, I'm going to put out a couple of scout baits, just some little feathers. You can use little jet heads, little anything with a mylar or a rubber skirt or some feather. Okay, it's going to catch the dolphin. It's a reactionary strike. That's all that it is. Something about 4 inches is all that you need. Fishing it on a 7 foot, 20 pound class spinner with an Isla size 7,000 reel. I choose this because there's a lot of line capacity on this reel. It's really, it'll hold as much line as a small conventional outfit. So I control this really confidently. And even though trolling spinning rods is unconventional, who says? I mean, if that's what you have, then that's what you're going to use and you'll catch fish. Make sure your drag is set properly, put it way out there behind the boat, and it's going to work. So again, it's loaded with 20 pound mono, plenty of line capacity, smooth drag, but my lure also has a heavy leader. This is 130 pound. Why? Because, well, elephants eat peanuts and you never know what you're gonna hook on that small feather. So I'm gonna be able to nail that fish on this outfit. Once we're on that bite, once we hook a fish and slowly we bring that school to the boat and we're chumming and we're throwing our chunks and the fish are around, I'm then gonna turn to a 20 pound, you know, spinning rod. This is a little bit different, a little bit shorter, okay? Incredibly powerful, loaded with 20 pound braid. So again, I've got 500 yards of line on here. Plenty of line capacity. I can handle big dolphin on this rod, but it's ultra comfortable, really light, and I could throw very light baits. I can hide a chunk or hide a hook in a small chunk and throw it out there. 20 pound braid, a top shot of 30 pound diamond presentation fluorocarbon. But I'm always ready to switch up that leader based on the conditions. And then finally, a 7, 7.5 foot spinner, 8 to 17 pound class, really light. This is what you're gonna use snook fishing, red fishing, bonefish. I mean, there's so many different species I've caught on this outfit. Loaded with a little black and gold, size 4,000 reel, loaded with 10 pound braid. Again, plenty of line capacity, 20 pound fluorocarbon leader, and we're using this to throw artificial lures, swim baits, top waters, twitch baits, stick baits, just a variety of different stuff. When the school comes around the boat, we know what size fish we're targeting. We're looking at them. It's sight fishing. I'm not throwing a bait at a 30, 40 pound dolphin on this little 10 pound outfit. That would be a mistake. I'm using this for these little schoolies, the 3 to 8 pound fish. So again, it's all about paying attention to what's going on around you and choosing the appropriate rod. But with these three spinners, I'm able to cover all of the bases. And I'll tell you what, I can come out here, I could have a great day on the water chasing the dolphin, and I can be just as successful as somebody else who's got a full arsenal of trolling gear.